Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India. Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jaffrey. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 5th of June. Religious places in India prepare ahead of reopening after virus lockdown. Balochistan erupts in protests over a murdered mother and her injured child. And 26 Nepalis stranded in Myanmar return home. And now for all the details, religious places, shopping malls and hotels across India have started preparations for reopening from June 8th onwards after being shut for more than 2 months due to nationwide lockdown. The government has allowed places of worship, retail sector and hospitality services to reopen despite a record high number of coronavirus cases detected countrywide.
Religious places across India started preparations for reopening on Friday after being shut for more than 2 months due to nationwide coronavirus lockdown. Places of worship, along with hotels, restaurants, shopping malls and markets are expected to reopen from Monday, as per the instructions of India's Interior Ministry, despite positive cases mounting. As precautionary measures, religious places have issued social distancing guidelines, installed sanitizer dispensers, decided to stop giving edible offerings and disinfecting after regular intervals. However, with increasing cases, the places of worship face a huge challenge to keep their premises COVID-free.
के अंदर जाने का, बाहर निकलने का हम विशेष प्रबंध करेंगे, सोशल डिस्टेंस भी रखेंगे और हर जगह हाथ सैनिटाइज करने वास्ते हमने वो मशीनें मंगवा ली हैं, वो भी लगवाएंगे और खास करके जो हेड कवर करने के लिए रुमाल है, वो हमने संगत को बोल दिया है.
Meanwhile, the staff of a hotel in India's eastern Patna city was also witnessed preparing for the reopening from Monday. The government on May 30th allowed hospitality and also retail sectors to open from June 8 as part of its unlock phase 1 plan, expecting authorities to ensure physical distancing rules and staggered business hours.
वो सारे norms जो कि government के द्वारा है, वो सारे हम लोग follow कर रहे हैं. जैसा कि आप लोगों को मैंने दिखाया कि हैंड सैनिटाइज करना है, हैंड वॉश करना है, फिर फुल बॉडी सैनिटाइज होना है और जो भी प्रोसीजर है, चाहे वो दूरी मेंटेन करने के प्रोसीजर हो.
The total number of coronavirus cases in India crossed 227,000 with 6,348 deaths as of Friday.
Search operations continued on Friday in Rajouri district of India's Jammu and Kashmir, where one terrorist was gunned down in an encounter by security forces late on Thursday. Despite the COVID-19 pandemic, there has been a sudden spurt in terror attacks and infiltration bids from Pakistan's side in the Kashmir Valley.
One terrorist was neutralized by security forces in an encounter in Rajouri district of India's Jammu and Kashmir late on Thursday. The encounter broke out as cordon and search operations were launched in Kalakot area in Rajouri based upon specific inputs. Search operations continued on Friday looking for more terrorists who may be hiding in the area.
को एक इंफॉर्मेशन मौसूल हुई थी और सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेस ने एक ऑपरेशन लॉन्च किया था. इन द एक्सचेंज ऑफ फायर एक टेररिस्ट मारा गया है. आर्म्स एंड एमुनिशंस रिकवर हुए हैं. ऑपरेशन अभी भी जारी है.
सिक्योरिटी ऑफिशियल्स डिड नॉट गिव द एग्जैक्ट नंबर ऑफ सस्पेक्टेड टेररिस्ट हाइडिंग इन द एरिया एंड द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ द स्लेन टेररिस्ट, कॉलिंग इट एन ऑपरेशनल मैटर. डिस्पाइट द कोविड-19 पैंडेमिक, देयर हैज बीन अ सडन स्पाइक इन टेरर अटैक्स इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड इन्फिल्ट्रेशन बिड्स फ्रॉम द पाकिस्तान साइड.
In news from Pakistan, the coronavirus situation is worsening day by day in Pakistan as the total number of cases in the country have crossed the 80,000 mark with at least 1,816 confirmed deaths. The spike comes after government lifted its lockdown in May, reopening transport and most businesses.
The number of confirmed COVID-19 cases in Pakistan rose to 89,249 on Friday after new infections were confirmed in the country. The death toll from the infection has increased to 1,816 after more than 80 fatalities were reported in last 24 hours. The spike comes after Pakistan lifted its two-month-long coronavirus lockdown last month. Prime Minister Imran Khan announced a phased lifting, saying despite rising infections and deaths, the country would need to learn to live with the virus to avert pushing tens of millions living on daily wages into destitution. Meanwhile, with coronavirus situation worsening day by day in the country, Pakistan is also repatriating its nationals stranded in different parts of the world. According to the Foreign Ministry, a total of 51,593 Pakistani nationals who had been stranded abroad have been repatriated so far. Pakistan's outbreak has grown steadily since the country's first case in February. The country has barely 3,000 intensive care beds, serving a population of 220 million.
Moving on. Protests have erupted across Balochistan to demand justice for four-year-old girl who was allegedly shot along with her mother by Pakistan Army-backed criminals known as death squads.
Protests have erupted across Balochistan to demand justice for four-year-old Bramsh, who was allegedly shot along with her mother in Turbat City by Pakistan Army-backed criminals known as death squads. The incident happened in the wee hours on May 31 when criminals barged into the house of Malik Naz in Dannuk area and started firing. Naz was shot dead and her four-year-old daughter Bramsh got seriously injured. After hearing the gunshots, nearby residents captured one of the criminals identified as Altaf Mazar, who revealed the link with death squads outsourced by the army for killing and abducting Baloch people.
So this is Balochistan's Baloch Lives Matter protest, which demands justice for Bramsh. And this is not the first or the last incident, because we know the mentality of Pakistan, Pakistan's army, Pakistan's military intelligence, Pakistan's ISI.
Activists have long expressed concern over sharp rise in enforced disappearances and killings of political activists and civilians by Pakistani security agencies along with terror groups. They blame thousands in the region have been internally displaced because of armed conflicts and army operations over the years.
Fish farmers in illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan stare at huge loss due to coronavirus lockdown. Apart from fishing industry, shopkeepers, hoteliers and other small businesses in the region are also facing an acute crisis.
Nature has bestowed Gilgit-Baltistan with abundant freshwater resources that are being suited for fish farming. Fish farming, especially trout farming, offer a potential source of income, especially during the summer times when the region receives thousands of domestic and international tourists. But the livelihoods for fishermen in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan has been affected due to the lockdown imposed to prevent the spread of the novel coronavirus. With their day-to-day livelihood hit, fishermen in Gizar district of Gilgit-Baltistan said they wanted subsidy or relief during the time of the crisis from the government. Gilgit-Baltistan has already reported 852 coronavirus cases but has no medical infrastructure to deal with the crisis. The occupied territory has been facing lockdown for over 2 months and lack of planning and supplies of essential commodities is making people upset. Apart from fishing industry, shopkeepers, hoteliers and other small businesses in the region are also facing an acute crisis.
A Myanmar Air Force aircraft carrying 26 stranded Nepali nationals arrived in Nepal's capital Kathmandu on Friday. The flight brought back home the people corresponding to the government's plan to evacuate Nepalis stranded abroad. Meanwhile, Nepal's health ministry has proposed to declare health emergency in the country as the number of active coronavirus cases has surpassed 2,000 mark.
A total of 26 Nepali nationals who were stranded in Myanmar due to the COVID-19 lockdown and sudden closure of the flights were flown back to Nepal on Friday. A Myanmar Air Force aircraft brought in the Nepali nationals and flew back with its nationals who were stranded in the Himalayan nation over 2 months. The airlifted nationals will now be kept in holding center built on by Nepal Army and then sent to their home where they will be placed under home quarantine. Meanwhile, the formal evacuation of stranded Nepali citizens from abroad is yet to be finalized by the authorities. Nepal on Thursday recorded its highest single-day increase in the coronavirus cases with 334 new infections. As on Friday, the total number of cases has risen to 2,634, many of them from areas near Indian border. The death toll due to COVID-19 rose to 10. Nepal's health ministry spokesperson Bikash Devgota said that ministry has proposed to declare health emergency in the country as the number of coronavirus active cases has surpassed 2,000 mark. Health emergency will be implemented once the cabinet approves the proposal. The lockdown imposed by the government to fight the deadly virus has been extended until June 14. The domestic and the international flight operations have been suspended until June end.
Even after the first death from the novel coronavirus in Bangladesh's crowded Rohingya camp, the refugee leaders, aid workers and officials claim people with the virus symptoms are not being tested as they fear separation from families. Experts suspect a greater spread in the settlement in the near future.
In refugee camp of Bangladesh's Cox's Bazar, Rohingya leaders, aid workers and officials say people with coronavirus symptoms are not being tested as they fear separation from families despite the first death from the disease in the crowded settlement. A 71-year-old refugee became the first to die from the illness this week in the camps, home to more than 1 million Rohingya from Myanmar. 29 cases have been found since mid-May in the area, but only 339 tests have been carried out, leading experts to suspect a greater spread.
It's very difficult for population to accept to be taken away and to be on their own because at the end, in most of our facilities for any other pathology or you would have a caretaker and one member of your family able to come with you.
Infections in Bangladesh have climbed to over 57,000, including 673 other residents in Cox's Bazar district. Where the camps are, 35 of them are aid workers with the United Nations and non-profits.
People around the country are coming up with different ideas to spread awareness regarding coronavirus pandemic. Artists in India's northeastern Assam province have painted street walls in a market depicting COVID-19 warriors, which includes doctors and police.
Artists in India's northeastern Guwahati city painted coronavirus-themed artworks on walls to generate awareness about the deadly virus and appreciate frontline workers. As the world is currently battling with coronavirus, artists painted the graffiti resembling a microscopic image of coronavirus and urging people to stay at home in a bid to stop the virus spread. The art on the walls depicted COVID-19 warriors, which includes doctors, media workers and police.
हम लोग ये पेंटिंग के थ्रू मतलब लोगों को जागरूक कर रहे हैं कि कैसे सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग मेंटेन करना है, क्या करना है, और हम लोग थैंक्स भी दे रहे हैं सभी वॉरियर्स को जो भी हमने इस कोरोना में पार्टिसिपेट किए हैं, उन लोग को हम लोग हेल्प जो कर रहे हैं उनको धन्यवाद दे रहे हैं.
While northeastern provinces emerged with more infections, Assam reported 285 new COVID-19 cases, taking the total number of positive cases in the province to 2,115.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.